welding shop. Welding is a process of joining similar metals or dissimilar metals by fusion. This fusion can be done with the help of the heat. The heat can be generated by oxy-steam or gas welding, or by arc welding, or by resistance welding, or by chemical means. By chemical reaction also we can produce the heat generation. We have so many advantages in the welding. Wherever see we can use the welding. If you see for constructing the bridges, manufacturing of automobiles, car, if you are seeing the car, so many spot welding can be done with the J sheet, number of spot welding will do, and shipbuilding also will, there also we are using the welding, and railway, making the railway coaches also, we are doing the welding application. So many applications are there. So in this video, what we will do, we will show the one video of oxy-steam welding and another manual metal arc welding. For showing the demonstration, I am requesting Mr. Ramcharitraji. He will show the how the gas welding can be done, oxy-steam gas welding. This oxy-steam gas welding, he will show the flames of how the different flames can be generated. And other one, I am requesting Mr. Billu. He will demonstrate how to do this manual metal arc welding. So this is the oxy-steam gas welding setup. We have this oxy-steam cylinder here. So generally the color code of this cylinder is maroon here. Here we can see the regulator to control the pressure of the gas, and the pressure valves are there. One indicates the pressure of the cylinder and other valve indicates the pressure in the pipeline. So acetylene is a fuel gas, that's why this cylinder generally packed with porous material which is filled with acetone. This acetone will be filled with acetylene, and the hose which is connected to the acetylene cylinder is also having a color of red. And other cylinder is oxygen cylinder. The code of the color is black. The hose pipe used for this cylinder is in blue color. Here also we can see the regulator and pressure valves, which will indicate the pressure of the gas in the cylinder and pressure of in the pipeline also. And these two hoses are connected to the torch. This is called welding torch. In this, you can see these two gases are coming through different passages and it is connected to the torch. Here two needle valves are there. It will control the flow of the gases. These two gases mix will in the mixer chamber, and after ignition at the end of the nozzle, the flame will be generated. This is about welding torch. Let us see the tools. This is the emery paper to clean the metal surfaces of the metal to be joined. So this is the emery paper. And we already discussed about this gas welding torch. And this other torch is cutting torch. The difference between this welding gas welding torch and the cutting torch is, here we have the provision of this one lever. So with this we can apply the pressure, because for cutting of the metals we need a high pressure. So that pressure can be created by pressing this lever. Here we can see one thing. The name of this part is called flashback arrestor. Flashback arrestor, what it will do, it will not allow the flame from torch to the hose. Sometimes we can keep this flashback arrestor from hose to the regulator also, so that the flame will not go back from the hose to the cylinder. So this is the safety device. This is the simple terms we use for holding the jaw, and this is the spark lighter to ignite the torch. So these are the different filler rods we use for welding of different materials. The filler material should be same for welding the base metal. If it is a mild steel, so we have to use mild steel filler rod. For cast iron welding, we use this cast iron filler rod. For brass welding, we use brass filler rod. So this filler rod helps to deposit the material between the joint of the metals to be welded. This is the flux we apply during the oxyacetylene gas welding, so that it will form a slag on the surface of the weld bead, means it will protect the weld bead from the contamination. All these are the different size of nozzles. These nozzles are required because suppose we want to weld or cut the material of higher thickness, we need a bigger flame. For that we have to use bigger nozzle. We start from 0 to 50. And these are the safety devices, hand gloves, and these are the goggles we use for safety purpose. It will give the safety to the eye. The welding process, oxyacetylene gas welding. For that we have to open the valve of the acetylene gas cylinder, and with the help of the regulator we are releasing the gas. We can see the two measuring valves, the pressure it is showing, the pressure of the cylinder and the pressure in the hose also. Now we are opening the oxygen cylinder valve with the help of the spindle key. And here also we can see the pressure of the oxygen gas. So this is the time to ignite the torch. With the help of the spark lighter, we are igniting the torch. Now we are going to ignite the flame. For that, with the help of the spark lighter, now the flame is there. Now it is completely purely acetylene flame. Now you are going to make a neutral flame by equating the proportion of oxygen and acetylene. Neutral flame is ready. This neutral flame can be used for mild steel and low carbon steel. Flame is carburizing flame. For that we have to increase the acetylene flame than the oxygen. With this carburizing flame, generally we weld for high carbon steels and cast iron, because of this excess acetylene that will dissolve in the metal and produces hard and brittle. That's why we use for cast iron and high carbon steels. Now we are making this oxidizing flame by increasing the oxygen content than the acetylene. So we will get the hissing sound also now here.
Oxygen.
So this is the oxidizing flame having more oxygen than the acetylene. That acetylene to oxygen ratio is 1.5:1. With this oxidizing flame we can use brass welding. We can use for brass welding. So now we are starting the welding. We are applying the filler material. The filler material is melting and depositing between the plates. This is the mild steel filler rod and joining the mild steel plates. Initially we are given the two tacks at the ends so that the plate will be firmly placed. We can easily weld, continuous weld after this one. Welding is completed. We can see the completed weld. Manual metal arc welding. In this manual metal arc welding, we have the power source, the metal transformer. From this, two cables are coming. One cable will be connected to electrode holder. And other cable is connected to the plate. You can see a cable there. In the total welding bench, we are keeping the material here. This is the electric holder holding the electrode. Here are the two metals to be welded. And we can see other tools also. So these are the electrodes. Hand gloves for safety. Face shield. Chipping hammer to take out the slag formed on the weld bead, tongs to hold the metal, web brush to clean that chipped material, chipped slag. So this is the electrode. When we strike the electrode with the plate, arc will be generated between the electrode and the base plate. In that arc heat, the electrode will melt and deposits in between the plates. The weld will be completed. And if you observe the electrode carefully, here is the base metal rod here, and it is covered with the flux. This flux will melt and form slags which will cover the weld bead and will protect the metal pool from the oxidation. Current setting first we have done, and we are switch on in the transformer. First of all, we have to do tag weld. Now tag weld is completed. You can see these two tags. After tag welding, also we have to chip this slag material. This slag material is formed because of the reaction of the flux. Flux is melted. Now welding is completed. We can see some slag is there over the weld bead. This slag has to clean with the help of the chipping hammer. With the help of the wire brush, we are cleaning the weld bead. Now our weld is ready.